thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. You're a good, good Father.
Bye.
excited to be here with you. For you are my Father, and I am your child. You are my Father, and I am your child.
Deliverance
blood flows through my veins, and I'm no longer a slave to fear. were drowned in perfect love. You're asking me so I could stand and sing. I am a child of God. You split the sea so I could walk right through it. My fears were drowned. So I could walk right through it. My fears were drowned in perfect love. You're asking me so I could stand and sing. I am a child of God. I am a child.
That you are a good father. That is who you are, and nothing can change that. That you are the perfect father. Where our earthly fathers may have failed us, we know, Lord, that you are the perfect father, that you lack in nothing, that you are perfected. So we can find confidence in who you are, and whatever we face, we can find confidence in your love. We can find safety in your arms. So tonight, we recognize who you are as Father. And we want to sing to you from this place. We want to pray from this place, truly recognizing who you are. So we will now be going into a time of worship in the Word. I will be speaking out the Word in praying. Then we will sing a new song from Scripture. So I invite you to open up your Bibles to Isaiah 62. And I encourage you to follow along as I read. Then afterward, feel free to meditate on the Scripture, to journal, to sing along, or just to be silent and receive. 62, and tonight we'll be looking at verses, starting from verse 6. Okay, verse 6 and 7. On your walls, O Jerusalem, I have set watchmen. All the day and all the night, they shall never be silent. You who put the Lord in remembrance, take no rest and give him no rest until he establishes Jerusalem and makes it a praise in the earth. Lord, we recognize that you have set the watchmen, that you have placed them on the wall to look to watch out for the ways that you are moving, to take their place and to give you no rest, to know your heart and to pray it out, to stand in that place in the Spirit. So we pray, oh Lord, that in this place right now, that we would recognize ourselves as watchmen on the wall, that we would give a greater clarity of what it means to be watchmen, that you would bring a greater revelation to us tonight. And that in us will just rise, that you're just stirring our hearts to really take our stand, to really take our place as watchmen on the wall, and to give you no rest. Because we know your promises, we know, what your kingdom looks like as you have revealed it to us. So tonight, Lord, we ask that you would just take us deeper in this revelation of what it means to be watchmen on the wall.
Be silent, oh, we will not be silent. we wait for your word to come to pass.
Anoint us with your oil, fill us with your Holy Spirit. Anoint us with your oil so that we may go.
For there is coming a day, oh, there is coming a day when Jerusalem the praise of the earth. Oh, there is coming a day when she will shine with all your splendor. Oh, there is coming a day we will give you no rest.
Jerusalem is the praise of the earth. God, what is not is too, and we will speak forth what will be.
She will shine, she will arise with the glory of the Lord over.
Establish Jerusalem, establish her in praise, establish her in your glory, Lord.
Oh God, hear the song of your watchmen. Hear the song of your watchman. Day and night, night and day, we will give you no rest. Hear the sound of your watchman. Hear the sound of your watchman. Day and night, night and day, we will give you no rest. Hear the sound of your watchman. Hear the sound of your watchman. Your watchman, hear the sound of your watchman. Day and night, night and day, we will give you no rest. Hear the sound of your watchman.
Hear the sound.
Hear the sound of your watchman. Day and night, night and day, we will give you no rest. Hear the sound of your watchman. Sound of your watchman. Day and night, night and day, we will give you no rest.
We will give you no rest.
Day and night, night and day, we will give you no rest. Day and night, night and day, we will give you no rest. Day and night, night and day, we will give you no rest.
The Lord has sworn by his right hand and by his mighty arm, I will not again give your grain to be food for your enemies, and foreigners shall not drink your wine for which you have labored. But those who garner it shall eat it and praise the Lord, and those who gather it shall drink it in the courts of my sanctuary. Lord, you say it in your word, that you have promised that you will bless your people, that the enemy shall not prevail, but there is victory in you, that your people shall prosper, that they shall eat the fruit of their labors. So, Lord, we give you the praise. We recognize, Lord, that it is you who shall do this thing, O Lord, and we give you the praise. For the harvest, we give you the praise for the fruit. And we just delight, yeah, in every single blessing that you give and that you will pour out.
He has promised
Forgotten you, he is faithful to the end.
Welcoming, and you're always loving. So recognize that in you that there is victory, that in you we can find our fullness and our safety, and we can find the fullness of love because you are love. So we run into the arms of the Father and we say, yeah, that we want to just know just what it means to go deeper into your love.
Speaks a better word. Your blood speaks.
for now, no condemnation. Those who are in Christ Jesus, where are your accusers now? Where are your accusers now? There is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Where are your accusers now?
You put a robe upon my back. You
throw your arms around me and say, you are my son, my daughter, don't forget. You put a ring upon my finger, you put a robe upon my bed. You throw your arms around me and say, you are my son, my daughter, don't forget. You put a ring upon my finger, you put a robe upon my bed. You throw your arms around me and say, you are my son, my daughter, don't forget.
Build up the highway, clear of stones, lift up a signal over the peoples. God, you call us to make a way for others, not only to be blessed and know our identity in you and have confidence in you, but to declare and make a way for others. So we say, Lord, here we are to take our stand too, just through prayer, Lord, and just through intercession to make a way and to declare that there is a way and it is pointing to Jesus Christ. There is a way and it is pointing to freedom in you. So we just remove any obstacle that is in the way. We remove the stones, we remove fear, we remove discouragement and hopelessness. But we declare that there is hope rising up. We lift up a signal over the peoples and we declare that there is victory and that Jesus Christ is the way.
Coming soon. Oh, your perfect love is coming soon. prepare the way of the Lord. 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 Prepare the way of
the way of the Lord.
Prepare the way.
Salvation comes. Behold, his reward is with him, and his recompense before him. We say to the daughter of Zion, we say to your the lost sons and daughters, or those who are yet to find you, that your salvation has come. It is here. It is Jesus Christ. Your reward is with him. Your reward is in him. So open your eyes. Be awakened and see that your salvation is here.
Oh, daughters of Zion, see your salvation comes. Behold, the Lord has not forgotten you. Salvation is here. Salvation is here. Behold your joyous come. Behold your joyous come in Jesus Christ. There's none like you, the nations will cry. Jesus, there's none like you. Jesus, there's none like you. Jesus, there's none like you, the nations will cry out. Jesus, there's none like you.
Jesus, there's none like you.
Jesus, there's none like you. The nations will prophesy. Jesus, there's none like you. Jesus, there's none like you. Jesus, there's none like you. The nations will declare. Jesus, there's none like you. Jesus, there's none like you. Jesus, there's none like you. All the people cry. Jesus, there's none like you. Jesus, there's none like you.
Called sought out, a city not forsaken. God, you call your people set apart. You call them holy unto you. You call them that you say that they belong to you, that you cover them, that you are for them, that you are jealous for them, that you seek them out. They are not forsaken by you. We just come into agreement that they belong to you. So we just pray, oh God, that you awaken your people just to this revelation that they are set apart, that they are loved, that they have a loving Father, They belong to you.
Oh God, when you speak over us, oh, everything changes. Everything changes at the sound of your voice.
You are making things new. You are setting us apart.
You say they are your holy people, they are the redeemed. Oh, they are desire, they are not forgotten.
You are undoing everything, every name, every curse, undoing and taking back your children. They are yours.
You claim them as your own. Claim them as your own, God. You give them a new name. You give them a new name.
They are sought after. They are yours. They are a holy nation.
You call them my beloved. You call them my beloved. You call them my beloved. Jerusalem, you have a father. You have a father.
a good father to Israel. You're a good father to your people. So we thank you, O Lord, that you continue to reveal yourself to them, that you are just doing a deeper work even now as we sing out these songs, yeah, of proclamations, just of promises, that you are just pleased with your people. You call them to yourself. Authority in Christ. So as I lead out in prayer, come into agreement with me, and then afterward lift up your own intercession to the Lord. So just feel a lot of freedom to shout things out, to clap hands, to stand up or walk around as you feel led. Okay, so the government mountain. We declare that Jesus Christ is Lord and King over Israel. And over the government in Israel, we declare that it belongs to you, Lord. So we establish every single leader in Israel's government in you, that they may walk in justice, they may walk in righteousness in your sight, to govern from a place that is pleasing in your eyes, to govern from a place that will be a blessing to the nation, and to prosper it. To prosper Israel. So we pray for the laws in Israel. We pray that the government will make decisions that will bless the people, that really will have your heart, Lord, that really based upon your truths, and that they would not only be made, but also that they would be executed outrightly and properly within the nation. Specifically to help the widows, to help the orphans, to help the foreigner, to help those who are oppressed and who are in need, because we know, Lord, that your heart is for these. Yeah, so let's pray. what as your word says at the beginning in Genesis, that man is made in the image of God. So there is value in every single being, every single human being. So we pray, Lord, that you would just awaken this truth in hearts and minds, that it would really be a place of life through honor, whether it is through those in greater authority or greed, or those under authority, that life would really be shown through honor and just valuing each other's gifts and talents, and just honoring the life that you have given every single one of them. We pray, we just bind all fear and hate and strife and envy and jealousy in hearts that may be present. That it really eyes would be open to see past these things, and that hearts would just be softened, and there would be a grace to forgive any hurt or pain that may have happened between peers, between leaders, between those under the leadership. We know, Lord, that as forgiveness goes forth, that life truly is released. So we just pray for the fear of the Lord, the fear and just a love for your truth and for understanding of a human value, because man is made in the image of God. Let's pray. Wisdom for those who really ask for it, oh Lord. So we just pray for the government officials, Lord, that they would just desire to know more of your wisdom, that they truly value and truly love her, really love wisdom, and really seek it out. That that they would be able to gain deeper understanding, gain deeper knowledge, gain deeper truths, to really to be a blessing to Israel, to be a blessing to the nation. So we just come against all distractions. We come against all apathy. We come against all spiritual blindness. And we pray, oh God, eyes to be open, and just a lifting of any heaviness. And we just declare just a light to invade the government mountain, and to bring your truth, to bring wisdom. So we know, Lord, that, yeah, that you love wisdom so much, and that this is where that your kingdom values can truly be established and to be a blessing to the rest of Israel. So we pray, oh Lord, by your Holy Spirit, that to the government officials, that you would just release the spirit of wisdom and you would release insight to them to better bless the nation. Let's pray. Walk in the authority that you have given him, to not be swayed to and fro, Lord, but to really know the authority that you have given in the place, the current place that you have given him, and that he would continue to move from a place of strength and peace, and out of a place of joy as well. And we just come against any curse that is spoken against him, and we disallow it from touching him. We just break it off right now in Jesus' name. And we just speak life upon him, and just not only him, but also his family. We bless his wife, and we bless his children. We pray, oh Lord, that they would experience and be awakened to the blessing that you have given them, that you have given them so much to be a blessing to the rest of Israel. Yeah, so at this time, we just want to just pray over different areas upon the president's life and his family's, his finances, his relationships, and just a place of authority that he walks in. Okay, let's pray. Officials, yeah, within the government. And we pray, oh Lord, that you would really, yeah, we cover them with your love, oh God, we cover them with your peace. And we thank you, Lord, that your love, your perfect love casts out all fear. So we pray, oh God, that they really govern out of a place of justice and righteousness, and out of the place of for authority which you have given them, and out of a place of peace, that really seek the good of Israel and the nation.
Restores the soul. You're making me like you.
Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. You will be praised.
Lord God, that you've given them, Lord God, still stands, that you have not forgotten them, you have not left them nor forsaken them, but you're a God who has made a covenant with them, and Lord God, you will see to it that every word that you've spoken, Lord God, comes to pass. We thank you, God, for the work that you are doing at this hour. We thank you, God, for the privilege of being able to pray and partner with your heart, Lord God, for your people. And until we see Jerusalem being established as the praise of the earth, Lord God, we will stand as watchmen on your walls that will not be silent day nor night, Lord God, people that will not give you any rest, Lord God, until we see your promises come to pass. We thank you, God, for the work that you are doing at this hour. We love you, Lord, and we pray these things in your name. Amen. Amen. Thank you guys for joining us tonight. I hope that you are blessed. And I hope that it's been a blessing just this past month. If you've been partnering with us here every Tuesday, we've been praying for Israel. Hopefully, God has been cultivating your heart for his nation. So I hope that this has been a blessing for you. And starting next week, we'll be praying on Tuesday nights for the nation of North Korea. So we hope to see you then. If you have nothing better to do tomorrow morning, and you don't need much sleep, come back tomorrow morning. We have a 9:30 a.m. watch here. So we'd love for you to join us as well. Have a wonderful night.